Hi friends, welcome back to Angular unit testing series. In this series, I'm talking about unit testing in Angular using Jasmine framework. In the last video, I have explained about how we can test an Angular component having DOM interactions. In this video, let's see about how we can test asynchronous operations. Let me take our last example. In this, we have a button when it is clicked. After 3 seconds, the button is getting disabled. You can think of this like we are calling an API. After 3 seconds, we are getting the response from the API, and based on the response, we need to disable this button. We have seen initially our test case was failing, and after we introduced a set timeout, our test case passed. But we have also faced one weird scenario. After the button is clicked, it should be disabled after 3 seconds. And so we are expecting this to be true. Also, we are seeing our test case is passing. Now let me expect this to be false. And so our test case should fail. But unfortunately, we can see now also our test case is passing. How can this be possible? Let me explain. If you inspect, we can see an error. Expect was used when there was no current spec. That means this expect code was executed after our test runner has completed the execution. That means when our test runner was running, we were not at all testing this. And so, regardless of the result, test runner is marking this as complete. That is why in my previous video, I have mentioned this way of testing is wrong. So, how can we test the asynchronous operations? We may need to make the test runner wait for these code to execute. For that, Jasmine is providing us a callback function called done, which is of type done function. I have just added that. Now let's see. Our test case is failing now, but with a different error message. It says async function did not complete within 5000 milliseconds. That means 5 seconds. That is the default timeout. After we add the done callback, Jasmine is able to identify about this async function, but the completion of this async function has not been informed to Jasmine. And so it is keep on waiting. Once it crossed the timeout, it is failing the test case. So we need to inform the completion to Jasmine. We can do that by simply calling the done function here. Now we can see our test case is passing. Now if I expect this to be false, we can see our test case is failing because now only it is really testing the test cases. Let me revert it. And so we can see it is passing. Okay, let me show this scenario. Let me have a set timeout before this. And let me execute this after 8 seconds. Assume we have some test cases inside this, which needs to be executed after 8 seconds. Now let's see how test runner is running. We can see the test runner has completed the execution. But after that, this code is running. Because before the execution of this code, we have informed the test runner that the test execution is completed. And so, we may need to move this done function call to here based on the timeout. But now, we are getting the timeout error because we have crossed the default timeout. In most cases, we may not be able to find the exact duration when we are going to get the response. Also, think about a nested set timeout or a set timeout inside a set interval or vice versa. So, even though this approach is correct, this is not convenient. Especially in complex components where we have multiple asynchronous operations. And so I am going to show you another approach. That is using Jasmine's another test utility called fakeAsync. Actually, in Angular, when there is a button click or whenever there is an asynchronous operation happened, Angular runs change reduction to find out whether the view has to be updated or not. And Angular makes use of zone, which is a context that detects the asynchronous operations. And fakeAsync test utility makes use of zone and wait for all the asynchronous operations to complete before marking the test as complete. Let's use that. First, let me comment this and keep this for reference. And then let me remove the done callback function from here. And so we can see this error. Expect was used when there was no current spec. Okay, let's use fakeAsync. To use that, we need to wrap this inside fakeAsync function. Like this. Now we can see our test case is failing. It says 3 timers still in queue. That means it has identified 3 asynchronous operations need to be completed. One is this fixture.detect changes, and the other two are these set timeouts. If I comment this one, we can see 2 timers still in queue. Let me uncomment this. And so it is waiting for 3 asynchronous operations to complete. So inside this, we need to simulate the passage of time. We can achieve that using the tick function, which accepts a time in milliseconds and advances the clock inside fake async zone. Let me advance the clock to 3 seconds. Now we can see 1 timer is still in the queue. Let me change this to 8000. Now we can see our test is completed. But this time, as we have advanced the clock, it is not actually taking 8 seconds. And so we have not exceeded the default timeout. Another advantage of this is, now we don't want to execute the expect inside the set timeout block. We can also call the tick with 3000 milliseconds, and then we can test these 2 cases, and then we can advance the clock to another 5 seconds and execute this one, like this. So we can see our test case is still passing. But even here, we have not yet overcome one more problem. We are using hard-coded times here, but in reality, we are not aware of the exact time we get the response from an asynchronous HTTP call. Here we have used 3 seconds, but if the response is coming after 3 seconds, this will not work. For that, instead of tick, we have another utility function called flush. That will make sure it will wait for all the asynchronous operations to complete. So let me comment this and use flush. Now we can see our test is passing. That's all for today. Please like this video and support me. I'll be back with next concept soon. Thank you. Bye.